question.
I'm John Ellis. I'm a theoretical physicist. What is my favorite theory? I'm going to have to say string theory. Of course, the Standard Model is fantastic, and that describes all the visible matter in the universe, but we need something else. There's lots of other puzzles that we don't know the answers to. And I think eventually we're going to want to make a quantum theory of gravity. And for that, I think string theory is the only possible candidate. It's an incredibly beautiful, incredibly powerful theory, and that's my favorite. If I could choose a superpower, what would it be? I would just like to think more clearly. Is it possible to erase a white or blackboard without permission? You bet. Here in Switzerland at CERN, if we want to preserve our blackboard or whiteboard, we have to write LSVP up in the corner. Otherwise, when you come back the following day, it may have disappeared. Fortunately, the writing on my blackboard never seems to disappear. It just gets more and more layers of it as time goes on. What is my favorite animal? Well, as you can tell from my pullover, the answer has to be a penguin, which is a name I used to describe a certain type of diagram a long, long time ago. What is my favorite particle? Ah, that's an easy one. It has to be the Higgs boson. What have I learned working here? I've learned to work with and appreciate people from many different countries who, you know, may be thinking many very different ways, but that actually helps us do science together. If I was made of dark matter, how could I contact you? That would be very, very difficult. Well, one way I could contact you is by exchanging gravitational force. So the evidence that we have for dark matter comes from its gravitational effects. So perhaps I could figure out a way of using those. But it may be that dark matter has other forces, other interactions, which might be stronger than gravity, which would make the job easier. Although I still think it'd be very, very difficult. Is dark matter black? If not, why is it called dark? Let me start with the second question. Why is it called dark? It's called dark because it doesn't emit any light that we can see. The only evidence we have for its existence is its gravitational effect. Now, it's possible that even though it doesn't emit light that we can see, or that we've seen so far, it's possible that it might emit a very, very small amount of light. It's possible that it might have other interactions, and we're looking for that in our experiments here at CERN and also in deep underground laboratories. So it might not be completely black, but it certainly is dark. Broken symmetry or supersymmetry? You know, the universe would be a very boring place if symmetries were not broken. For example, we have weak interactions which are responsible for forms of radioactivity. And we know that they're related by a symmetry to electricity and magnetism. But what would happen if that symmetry was not broken? Then radioactivity would be as important in the universe as light, and life would be impossible. The universe would be completely different. So I think we should be very, very glad that symmetries are broken. What is supersymmetry? Ah, supersymmetry, that's a beautiful theory that tries to relate particles that spin at different rates. So I should explain. So particles, all particles, except the Higgs boson, are rotating around an axis. They spin at different speeds. So the electron spins relatively slowly. The photon, that also spins, but at a higher speed. And we have theories that can relate different particles that spin at the same rate. For example, we relate the electron to the neutrino. But supersymmetry is the only theory that we have that's capable of relating particles that spin at different speeds. So That's interesting in itself, but it can do all sorts of wonderful things theoretically, like it could help us understand why the Higgs boson has the weight, the mass that it does. It could help us unify the fundamental interactions. It's an essential ingredient in string theory. And my favorite is that it could also provide the dark matter that fills the universe. So it's a wonderful theory. If only we could find some evidence for it. Thank you very much for all your interesting questions. I hope you like the answers. This is a fairly heavily trafficked corridor.